Hold your breath. Make a wish. Count to three.
Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look, and you'll see into your imagination.
That's home. That's us.
The Vishuddhi is the chakra of the mind. It is the elemental expression of air and the seat of introspection, intellect, and imagination. It is a chakra of the right hand, and therefore, it is of a contemplative nature. Individuals rooted in the Vishuddhi possess a coolness that is indicative of the elemental nature of this state of consciousness.
How are you doing?
I'm overall okay. In the grand scheme of things, I can't complain.
Do you get lonely?
Sometimes, but I... You know, my kids and friends keep me company.
So not existential.
There are many nights I sleep alone. I don't have to, but I do.
We only have a few minutes, so try to be brief. Okay.
I would do absolutely anything you say.
Right.
Why did you call the movie Stop Making Sense?
Because it's good advice. Because music and performing does not make sense.
Amazing.
It is my job.
How did you ever think of that big suit? Why a big suit?
I like symmetry and geometric shapes. I wanted my head to appear smaller, and the easiest way to do that was to make my body bigger. Because music is very physical, and often the body understands it before the head.
This cool detachment facilitates an esoteric scientism and internalization, which is unique in that it is expressed in terms of intellectual manifestation.
The lives and deaths of the stars seem impossibly remote from human experience, and yet we're related in the most intimate way to their life cycles. The very matter that makes us up was generated long ago and far away in red giant stars.
Manifestation and the power of the mind is a core feature of Vishuddhi consciousness. Currently, we are living in the age of the Vishuddhi, and the energetic signature of this state of consciousness can be seen in the global culture. It is important to recognize the nature of the present age as it influences the manifestation and perception of Vishuddhi consciousness. By examining the present age, it is possible to identify the stream of imagination and manifestation that has led to the rise of modernity. Modernity is in fact synonymous with the age of Vishuddhi. It is the expression of the power of the mind and the desire for individuation from a point of conceptualization. In this age, man becomes God, and the elements of spirit, fire, and body are subject to the will of the mind. It is through the expression of Vishuddhi consciousness that the world has experienced a revolution in technology, industry, law, and philosophy. With these towering expressions of the mind has also come an atomization, existential nausea, and radical skepticism, which has permeated the global culture. All of these global expressions, the highs and lows, are potentialities that are present within each individual rooted in the Vishuddhi. Imagination is the great source of power and dissolution for the Vishuddhi yogin.
Thing I'm expressing all the time, but now I can put it into that sentence that I think we're being run by maniacs for maniacal ends, you know.
It is through the imagination that the Vishuddhi yogin constructs an individuated perception of the cosmos. In this way, the individual acts as a sort of cosmic engineer, projecting the internal construct onto the outside world. This internal construct is the thread of understanding for those rooted in the Vishuddhi, and it must be defended lest the individual lose all sense of identity.
Mr. Wonka?
I am extraordinarily busy, sir.
I just wanted to ask about the chocolate. The lifetime supply of chocolate for Charlie. When does he get it?
He doesn't.
Why not?
Because he broke the rules.
What rules? We didn't see any rules, did we, Charlie?
Wrong, sir. Wrong. Under Section 37B of the contract signed by him, it states quite clearly that all offers shall become null and void if, and you can read it for yourself in this photostatic copy, I, the undersigned, shall forfeit all rights, privileges, and licenses herein and herein contained, etc., etc., fax mentis, incendium gloria culpum, etc., etc., memo bis punitor delicatum. It's all there, black and white, clear as crystal. You stole fizzy lifting drinks. You bumped into the ceiling, which now has to be washed and sterilized, so you get nothing. You lose. Good day, sir.
In a well-adjusted individual, the internal construct is informed by a holistic analysis of external conditions. Such an analysis allows for the integration of the other elemental aspects of the cosmos.
What I do in my book, The Science Delusion, which is called Science Set Free in the United States, is take the 10 dogmas or assumptions of science and turn them into questions, seeing how well they stand up if you look at them scientifically. None of them stand up very well. As my friend Terence McKenna used to say, modern science is based on the principle, give us one free miracle and we'll explain the rest. And the one free miracle is the appearance of all the matter and energy in the universe and all the laws that govern it from nothing in a single instant.
In maladjustment, it is possible for the internal construct to disconnect from the external reality and enter into a contemplative spiral of self-affirming ideation that is not open to criticism.
Would you allow someone to teach the possibility that God created them in the public schools?
No, not in science class. Mm-hmm. In religion class, is history class, philosophy class, but that's not science.
But you said your belief was everything happened by natural processes, and they're teaching that religion in the science class.
Well, you're calling it a religion.
Yeah, it is.
We're calling it the process of science.
No, but it is a religion.
So you can teach...
It's a belief.
Teach your worldview in a different class, but not in science class. And I say to the grown-ups, if you want to deny evolution and live in your world that's completely inconsistent with everything we observe in the universe, that's fine. But don't make your kids do it, because we need them. We need scientifically literate voters and taxpayers for the future. We need people that can, we need engineers that can build stuff, solve problems.
When directed effectively, the imagination and power of manifestation within the Vishuddhi can lead to the creation of wondrous things.
We're looking at an old pump organ in a big empty space. The guts of the organ, the original guts, have been ripped out. The keys now pretty much act as switches. Pressing different keys, you activate different kinds of mechanical devices. There's no synthesizer stuff built in, no electronics in the sense of electronic sounds. There's no microphones or amplification. Everything is just done mechanically. So it really is kind of turning the building into an instrument. When you're playing it, you realize, oh, this one's coming from behind me, and this one's coming from way down there, and that one's coming from almost overhead. The middle ones are...
Now these are running on compressed air, right?
Those are running on compressed air. There's a big compressor in the other room.
Individuals rooted in the Vishuddhi will sometimes craft a dream world perfectly engineered as a reflection of their internal construct. Within this dream world, the Vishuddhi yogin is able to manifest an environment that is a mirror of their hopes and wishes. This is one of the primary means by which individuals in the Vishuddhi interact effectively with the outside world. They share the contents of their mind through the construction of new ideas and art pieces.
The indictment came after Theodore Kaczynski had spent 2 months in a Montana jail charged only with possessing bomb components.
So we kind of opened the door just a bit to the cabin. And as we opened the door, we were both pretty much overcome. As we looked across the cabin at the shelves that were built on the other side of the door, we could see coffee cans and bottles and jars, and they all had labels on them, and they were very meticulously done. And we could see that some were labeled with the name of certain chemicals. One of the things we saw was a hooded sweatshirt, that was hanging up there. And the cabin smelled as if you might start to think, if you really think about this. This is a person who lived in this cabin, had a cutaway spot in the floor to go to the bathroom in if he needed to, and had built fires in the cabin. There was an old potbelly stove in there.
I could do this all day. But I won't.
Greetings, beautiful mutants. My name is Mark Maluzba. Welcome to Mutato Musica. This is where a number of tortured artists have figured out ways to eke out a living in the Hollywood system. So come on in here. The building we're in, I painted it bright green about 25 years ago. It was originally a plastic surgeon's office. I come from the school of writing everything myself and orchestrating everything myself and being self-contained. But over the years, I've learned how to incorporate a team to work with me.
The animal that is traditionally associated with the Vishuddhi is the white elephant with 7 trunks. The Vishuddhi is the only chakra that is traditionally represented by a creature that does not exist in the present dimension of consciousness. This emphasizes the role of imagination in the effective operation of the Vishuddhi. Without the application of imagination, the Vishuddhi yogin may fail to conceive anything beyond the point of absolute detachment. This is the point of purity that is associated with the myth of Shiva's consumption of Halahala, the great poison. In the myth, the churning of the ocean of milk by the devas and asuras led to the production of the toxic Halahala. The Halahala threatened to destroy all life, but Shiva agreed to drink the poison, which was halted at his throat. The god's throat turned the color blue as the poison was purified. Blue is the color of the Vishuddhi, the chakra of purification, where the poisons of the outside world are diluted and the internal being reigns supreme. It is due to the purifying aspect of the Vishuddhi that individuals in this state can often seem cold and disconnected.
But time for the 35-year-old superstar is at a premium, so why come to Ireland just to promote a record?
Well, an excuse to come over here. I love it over here, and
record is as good excuse as any.
How old was Jodie Foster playing Taxi Driver? I was 12 years old when I made Taxi Driver. It was a summer, it was hot, and it was a terrible, terrible neighborhoods in New York, and I had to wear hot pants and a halter top and platform shoes, which made me really unhappy. I was a kid who liked to wear knee socks, but I knew I was doing something great, so that felt good.
Individuals in the Vishuddhi are often not moved by emotional expression in the same manner as individuals in other states. This is because the mind is both internalized and self-reflective.
Well, I don't believe in either heaven and hell as a place to go to, that when we die, we're going to go down and burn for a while, or if we're good, we're going to go up there and be happy for a while, or purgatory where all the poor unbaptized babies are hanging out. I think anybody who's got that kind of, anybody who came up with that idea that there's going to be a place where little children are going to be hanging out for the rest of their lives, is either the sickest person on earth or the most stupid person on earth.
The mind generally operates through the application of logic and reason in the exploration of the cosmos. And so individuals heavily rooted in the mind tend to be closed off to the perceived illogical aspects of passion and spiritual experience.
Dr. Quino, the high priest of the Church of Set,
Temple of Set.
Temple of Set, also a colonel, interestingly enough, in the United States Army. What is it, this Satanism?
I think that there is some confusion tonight because this same term means something different to Satanists than it does to Christians in the United States. By our own standards, the people who you've shown in these film clips would not be Satanists, either present or in the past. Rather, they would be the failures of a conventional religion.
I appreciate your opinion. What is it, sir, then? What is Satanism?
Well, originally the Church of Satan, when it was founded, was composed not of people with a hatred for Christianity, but of people who, by and large, were agnostics and atheists, because they felt that the institutions which had arisen around Christianity had failed in their moral commitment. So Satanism itself became an emphasis on rational self-interest and on taking responsibility for your own intellectual and ethical decisions.
Furthermore, the adversarial point to the Vishuddhi is the Manipura. The Manipura is the seat of fire and expression. Vishuddhi yogins who have not integrated the Manipura tend to be much cooler and introspective than those who have stimulated the inner fire at the Manipura. It is through the integration of the Manipura that the Vishuddhi yogin is able to connect with the material and increase their power of material manifestation. Ganesha is a deity that is associated with the Vishuddhi. Ganesha is a scholar who emphasizes the mind over the body. He is most often depicted as a fat man with an elephant head. Ganesha's fat body represents the potential for a decline in physical conditions for those individuals who fail to develop a connection to the body. It is through Ganesha's emphasis of the mind over the body that he has developed his out-of-shape physique. He is a representation of pure mind, and his condition emphasizes the disconnect between mind and body. Furthermore, Ganesha represents the consumptive aspect of the Vishuddhi. Individuals in the Vishuddhi tend to be great consumers of ideas. Ganesha, in his consumption of knowledge, has grown very fat. If the Vishuddhi yogin wishes to preserve a healthy connection to the body, it is important that a dharmic balance between the air of the Vishuddhi and the fire of the Manipura be developed.
I don't think you have a very good voice, but you're a singer. How do you do that?
The better the singer's voice, the harder it is to believe what they're saying. So I use my voice to an advantage.
In the eyes of the Vishuddhi yogin, we find a coolness that inspires calm, contemplation, and detachment. These are the eyes of the meditative Shiva. I call the eyes of the Vishuddhi Yogin inner vision. When observing the communicative element of the Vishuddhi, one can see how these individuals seem to be internally processing every expression, carefully crafting each idea before it is delivered.
It's all based on this one song on the record that is about that moment that they used to have in weddings where they would say, "Speak now or forever hold your peace." That moment is sort of a metaphor for waiting until it's too late to say something about whatever it is that you feel strongly about, waiting until it's too late. And instead of saying the wrong thing or saying something that you might be embarrassed by, you just say nothing. That's been a habit that I've had in my life, where if there's something that's just so, that I don't know what to say or I don't know what to think about, I just go silent until I know what to say, and that's usually when I write a song about it.
The intensity of the internal reflection that is present in this state of consciousness can serve the individual well if that individual is able to incorporate data from the external world. If external data is not incorporated effectively, the Vishuddhi Yogin may become so myopic that a heavy solipsism may form, leading to adharmic isolation. In the mind, there exists an inexhaustible stream of contemplation that allows for the formulation of ideas which may exist outside of manifestation. Manifestation is the point of solidification and expression of that which is contemplated. The great power of the Vishuddhi Yogin is the natural capacity for imaginative contemplation that can lead to the manifestation of new worlds. It is within the realm of potentiality and within the realm of dreams that individuals rooted in the Vishuddhi are able to construct a mental blueprint in alignment with their hopes and wishes. It is through the liberation of the mind and the individual that this planet has experienced the advancement of man as an object of his own design and imagination.